Welcome to the video lecture series of digital image processing. This is lecture number 24 and today's topic is image smoothing in frequency domain filtering. In today's lecture, you are going to study about the three types of filters, which is ideal low pass filter, Butterworth low pass filter and Gaussian low pass filter. Why these filters are used in the case of image smoothing. Let us begin. You have studied about spatial domain. You know about the frequency domain. So let us once again revise the concept. Spatial domain, in this case, if fxy is the input image, means it deals in the time domain, and hxy is the filter. So at the output, you are getting gxy, which is the enhanced image. So gxy can be written as the product of these two. In case of frequency domain, you can see FUV is what? This is the Fourier transform of the image fxy. HUV is the Fourier transform of this filter function, and accordingly at the output you are getting GU into V, and this can be written as GUV is what? FUV into H of UV. And original image GXY in the spatial domain can be reconstructed by taking the inverse Fourier transform. This is how the things happen in frequency domain. So now you can correlate what is the processing in the case of spatial domain and what happens in the case of the frequency domain. You must know that edges and other sharp transitions like noise in the gray level of an image contribute significantly to high frequency components, to its Fourier transform. Therefore, smoothing, that is blurring, is achieved in the frequency domain by attenuating a specific range of high frequency components in the transform of a given image. Filtering process can also be performed in frequency domain. I have told you about this. Frequency domain filtering process is based on image transforms. Frequency domain filters are used for smoothing and sharpening of images by removing high or low frequency components as per our requirements. Sometimes it is possible to remove very high and very low frequencies as well. Frequency domain filters are different from spatial domain because it focuses on the frequency of the image. This is the point you must remember. Why it is different from the spatial domain? Because it focuses on the image frequency. And frequency domain filtering is preferred over spatial domain because it involves less computation. Now, you have to study about the algorithm for frequency domain filtering. So, to study this algorithm, let me tell you what you understand by frequency domain mask and why it is being required. So, frequency domain mask can be designed depending on the application requirement, means it may vary from one application area to the other application. Therefore, by controlling the weights of frequency domain mask, we can control the attenuation of frequency components, and indirectly you can say we can control the nature of image enhancement. For smaller mask, if the mask is being taken for a smaller size like up to 9x9 size, a spatial domain is effective. But for larger mask, means if the mask size is more than 9x9, then filtering in frequency domain is preferred. So you can differentiate it on the basis of the size of mask as well, which type of domain is effective for the filtering. So now let us understand the frequency domain filtering algorithm in stepwise manner. Step 1, if fxy is the original image and on this image filtering is required. So first, what you have to do, you have to obtain the Fourier transform of the image and then there is a requirement to center the transform. It means multiply it with minus 1 raised to the power x plus y. Step 2. Then design a frequency domain filter matrix function which is denoted by hxy, and the shape of mask can be circle, rectangular or any other custom shapes depending upon the application requirement. Then obtain the Fourier transform of hxy, which is actually h of u comma v. Step 3 is multiply the Fourier transform of the filter, which is HUV, with the Fourier transform of the image, which is FUV, element wise. So it can be written as GUV is what? Multiplication of the Fourier transform of filter with the image. GUV is the filtered output in the frequency domain. Fourth step, apply the inverse transform to GUV to retrieve the filtered image in the spatial domain. What you need to do? You have to apply the inverse transform because GUV, which is the filtered output in frequency domain, from here you need to retrieve the image in the spatial domain. Then next step is step number 5. Extract the real components of the resultant and again multiply it with minus 1 raised to the power x plus y to offset the effect, because in the step number 1 we have multiplied it to center the like pattern. So here to offset that particular effect, again it needs to be multiplied with minus 1 raised to the power x plus y. And the last step is display the image and exit, means the entire operation is being completed. So this algorithm is general and it is used to implement many frequency domain filters. Some types of filters I am going to explain you in this particular lecture as well. The first type of image smoothing frequency domain filter is low pass filter. Let us study low pass filter for one dimensional and two dimensional signal. An ideal low pass filter allows all frequencies up to a certain cutoff frequency known as D0 and removes all other frequencies beyond that. Transfer function for ideal low pass filter can be written as HD, this is equal to 1 for all frequencies of D which is less than D0, and higher than D0, it would be 0. You can see from this particular diagram as well. So here all the frequencies greater than D0 are removed, and this filter gives the smooth effect to the image. Here actually what happens, the multiplication of this HD with image FU in one dimension preserves all the frequencies up to D0. This is how this low pass filter works. Two dimensional ideal low pass filter. Images are two dimensional. You are studying all the types of image for 2D, means being represented as fx, y. Therefore, HD should be first applied along the rows, and the result is stored in an intermediate stage. Then on this particular intermediate stage where intermediate image is being stored, the HD operation being applied along the columns as well. Therefore, it yields 2D mask. So what happens, because you know that the images are two dimensional, you can represent it as fx, y. Means in 2D, image can be represented as a rows and columns in matrix form. So what happened, first the HD should be applied along the rows and then it will be applied along the columns, and accordingly the whole operation will be executed. Ideal two-dimensional mask, which is written as HUV, can be designed as, this is what? achieve it will be 1 for all the frequencies which are less than D naught, means the cutoff frequency, and for higher frequencies it would be 0. You can see over here from this diagram the same thing, where DUV is what? It is square root of U square plus V square, and D naught is the cutoff frequency. However, a more effective approach is to use a single filter and then apply it radially on all frequencies of the image. So you have to select a mask, you need to design a mask. Which kind of mask and what could be the shape? Mask can be circular, rectangular, or any required customized shape, again depending upon the application. Finally, this radial distance need to be calculated, which is denoted as du, v. D naught is a positive constant, which is the cutoff frequency, and duv is the distance between a point uv in the frequency domain and the center of frequency rectangle. It can be written as mathematically duv is what? U minus T upon 2 its square plus V minus Q upon 2 its square, and overall its square root. Here DUV is the radial frequency, you know, which involves square root, because the origin of the image, which is of size M cross N, is entered in the frequency rectangle now. So what would be the U comma V? Here U comma V will be P by 2 and Q by 2. This is P upon 2 and Q upon 2. So now for two-dimensional, radially implemented filter D naught, whose cutoff frequency is D naught, is a positive constant, and in a circular mask the cutoff frequency is the radius of the circle. Next type of filter is Butterworth low pass filter. What do you understand from this Butterworth filter? It is a type of filter designed to have a frequency response as a flat as possible in the pass band, and it is also known as a maximally flat magnitude filter. So low pass Butterworth filter are also effective low pass filters, and they reduce or eliminate the ringing effect. Transfer function for Butterworth filter can be written as HUV is what? 1 upon the denominator term is 1 plus DUV upon D naught its power 2 raised to N. Here H represents the filter mass magnitude, and it ranges from 0 to 1. So the value of H may vary from 0 to 1. There is a factor N, you can see in the denominator. So if N increases, then the filter becomes sharper, but at the same time ringing effect increases in a spatial domain, which is not very much like required or the like accepting factor in the case of the Butterworth filter designing. If N is equal to 1, no ringing effect exists. If N is equal to 2, ringing is present but imperceptible. It means N is equal to 1 is the ideal case, but if you increase N from 1 to 2 up to certain value, then it may be present but can be acceptable up to a certain limit. Next is Gaussian low pass filter. You have studied about the low pass filter, Butterworth filters, and you must know that the problem with an ideal low pass filter is that it produces ringing artifacts. This is a visual effect where a series of lines in decreasing intensity lies parallel to the edges, and the ringing artifacts are also known as Gibbs ringing. Gibbs ringing is a very important term you have studied in your communication as well. So to avoid these artifacts, Gaussian low pass or Butterworth low pass filters are preferred. Gaussian low pass and Butterworth low pass filters are used to avoid ringing effect, and these filters do not have a steep profile similar to ideal filter. This is the important characteristic of a Gaussian low pass filter. The profile of a two-dimensional Gaussian filter can be written as HU is what? E raised to the power minus D square UV upon 2 sigma. Twice of this term, it's square. Here, you know that HUV is the magnitude of a two-dimensional Gaussian mask. And its value range from 0 to 1. And the value of sigma can be approximated as D naught. Then this particular equation is what? HUV e raised to the power minus. Numerator term will be D square UV upon 2 D naught square. So D naught is a cutoff frequency and the Gaussian profile is controlled by the value of sigma. Topic for the next class is image sharpening in frequency domain filtering. Thank you so much.